There are two questions I would like to ask to you this morning. Do we know His promise? And the second is, do we know what we will inherit? Sabi ba kita ni si promesa? Sabi ba kita kung saan man inherit? Here's the number. Manalat niya ang Allah sa araw sa promesa. Pregunta ko sa promesa. Kaya sa provide ng Lord na kay dadal ng mundo kay estate kay I'm not saying this is bad. But when we talk about the inheritance, the promise of God, we need to understand what really He's talking about. No. You know, we have not been bombarded that when we become Christians, we will have a good life in this world. That when we become Christians, there will be no problems. That when we become Christians, we are going to walk through a red carpet, lying down on a bed of roses. But as a matter of fact, it's the other way around. You know, there are teachings today that if you become a Christian, you will have your good life in this world. No, God never promised good life in this world. God promised an abundant life in heaven. This is one thing we need to understand. Hindi kay Abla, hindi kita pwede bibig when we make the data team, but who's the reality? It doesn't matter that the faithful who will face problems, who will be persecuted, we will go to trials, we will go to temptation. The good life is awaiting for us. In this world, we need to have God that we may go through the wilderness and reach the promised land. This is what we need to understand. So, do we know His promise? Sabi ba kita? Do we know what we will inherit? We will be answering those questions this morning. Klaro ba mga boses na atras?
Yes.
The passage from the book of Psalm chapter 2 verse 7 and 8 is a passage, it's a kind of passage that is known to be as a prophetic writing. A writing that prophesies about Jesus Christ. Por eso, ang mga inyat na kayong Kristo, kabar ito, pick and choose sila, kabar kita sila mga scriptura na Bible to what you call this, remove the deity of Christ, flash news, or news flash, the prophecy about Jesus Christ that starts by Genesis. So if you don't want that Jesus Christ is God or anything about Jesus, then don't read the Bible. Kontra kita-kita scriptura. Because abangan si Jesus, when you look for eternal life in the scripture, you will find out that the scripture speaks of Him. Because life and Christ are synonymous. So in this passage, it points to Christ. Listen to what the Bible says about Jesus Christ. Every knee shall bow and confess that Christ is Lord. All power in heaven and in earth has been given to Christ. The kingdom that shall know no end is the kingdom which Jesus Christ is going to rule. Because the passage in the book of Psalms, it says this, I will declare the decree the Lord hath said unto me. The reason why the book of Hebrews 1:8 says, and he saith to the Son, Thy throne, O God. It means, si chene throne, chene ruler. Kuya sa si tablati. I will declare the Lord and said to me, Thou art my Son, this day I have begotten thee. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen or the nation for thy inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. Hindi man intro na ako ano, na preaching o na sharing ara, but if you heard about the millennial reign, Jesus Christ is going to rule 1,000 years. And Satan wants to, Satan kasi gaya-gaya lang sila. para sa matatik-atik sa leksyon ng one world government. Now, originally, if we go to the book of Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 to 31, and bear with me, kay my microphone, so okay lang, you will read with me, okay lang ba? Let's read Genesis 1, 26 to 31. Okay, let's read all together, ready? Go! God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every living thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God made man in his own image, in the image of God created he, him, male and female, created he, them, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful, and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree, which is the fruit of the tree yielding seed to you, it shall be for meat. To every beast of the earth, and to every fowl of the earth, air, and every thing that creepeth upon the earth, wherein there is life, I have given everything from it, and it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was not good. The evening and the morning were. He created man in his own image. For what? Para kosa, to have dominion. Everybody say with me, dominion.
Dominion.
And yeah, for that, teaching the pastor Philip about dominion. Por que may teaching about dominion? Because in the first place, humans was given the authority to dominate, to have dominion. This was before Adam fell. Before the culpa. Remember these three things. Man was made in the image of God. Second, man or Adam was anointed or given authority to have dominion or to rule. And third, rule, but yes, to be okay. Have dominion or to rule means to respect, to understand, to love, and to equip. Because we are called, alam pa si Jesus, we are not like the heathens when we rule, dolagel pitabos, mandaki mandala. But we are called to minister and to serve, meaning to respect, to understand, and then to love and to equip everyone. This is how a dominion when it comes to godly things. The reason why Christ came. This is the reason why Christ came. Aside from being obedient to the Father and to bring salvation. Normally when we talk about Jesus came to world, at ang pensanan kita pirmi is to save me. Sin uwi kita at John 3:16, pirmi kita tali, he came because of me. Which is not bad, which is true. Pero before le, kunele yak uwi, before kunele yak laban na cross, este habla. Rason na binilegi. He was doing the will of the Father. He came here because it was the will also of the Father. But there's also one reason why he came to this world. Yes, first, to save us. But here's the one reason. To take back what the devil has stolen from us. Kosakel, dominion. the fall of Adam and Eve and to restore it. Pasakel. Christ came not only to save the lost, but to restore the fallen mankind to its original position. Hello, tawag kita?
Yes.
Pero porke man ara man ang Kristiyano, don't hindi man. Don't know why man. I mean, di ba yung level Bible? When we are child of God, we are empowered. Why is it most Christians are empowered to sleep and just sit on the couch? Why is it majority of the so-called believers are just comfortable and okay at kanila, abuyala ng iglesia, una bes, pero close kami ni Lord. Kaya ang laman share yung gospel, mabaho lang siya ni pastor. And then you expect many blessings from the Lord. Mas tayo nga niya pinunta, pastor, sino yung magpulpa si Adam and Eve? Inhentin niya trabaha? Dahil kayo, palito. May pa magpulpa si Adam and Eve? Dahil yung trabaho si Lord yung Adam. Ala pala, yung siya punin, yung nation, rule over them. It means be a manager. It's a work. To rule is a work. The world describes right now, if people, you are in authority, it means you are the boss. But in the eyes of God, when you are given the authority, you are called to serve. It's a work. To have dominion does not mean to sit down with wine on the right hand and grapes on the left hand. Kabachene ka na itong tatpaypay at sinay. Wala na kayente. No, we are called to work. Adi pa ba ustedes? Okay lang pa, water break. Ano yun? Sama yung ugalang basketball sudang, si Magkwento ko na rin, tasudang. Now, I have two questions again. Then I'm left with tayo, do you know the promise? Do you know what you inherit? Another question, do you know your stand before God? Do you know your identity? Grabe mang pastor, largo mang gayon, abde lang po sa inheritance, pangalo pa po, hindi anda. This is very important. Do we know our stand before God? Do we know our identity? The reason why normally we can pray and enter the throne of the Lord with boldness is because we do not know where we stand. And normally the reason why don't have confidence to speak of His word because we do not know our identity. The Bible says, speak boldly and you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Power means given the authority. It means this, you know your identity, you know where you stand, you know your faith. That's why you can speak with confidence. And when you speak with confidence, you speak in authority and boldness. Do we know where we stand? Sabi ba kita onte kita taparan? In the book of Genesis 13, 14 to 18, we can see the promise of God to Abraham. And the Lord said unto Abraham, after the blood was separated from him, lift up now thine eyes and look from the place where thou art, northward, southward, eastward, and westward, for all the land which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. Pastor, this speaks of Israel. Yes. But what I'm trying to let you understand is the principle of God. When He says He's going to do it and He promises it, He will do it. But, kinakita ko sa si Abraham. God promised the land to Abraham. Yes or no? Abraham, by faith, obediently followed the Lord. Yes or no? Lord, kaya tayo si Asya, Lord, pati para ko sa pamangyo man share din palabra, tan-bless naman ko kumigo. Basta dala ninyo tayo sa numbering, okay yun. Basta pwede lang nyo leon verse na undi yun, okay, Lord. I hope we don't have that mindset. Kasi si Asya pa dyan ang mindset. Marap yan ako si Abla. It means this, may sacrifice spiritually. That's the reality. Abraham was considered a friend of God. Why? Because of his faith. He was obedient. God saw his heart. Tinanong kaya pregunta na nadamon Sunday school, por qué daw ya iskuwigat po ng Israel? Remember, no ay pa Israel nation is Jacob is Israel. God chose Jacob who happens to be the son of Isaac. Isaac who happened to be the son of Abraham because the promise was to Abraham and his sons. It's very important kasi kita te connect hasta ligase ka na sa church age that we may understand the inheritance. And most of us do not understand it. Kasi si entender te kita, I will tell you honestly, if you understand this and take it seriously, you have the value of your career, but you will prioritize your inheritance that is coming from the Lord. Israel? Who is Israel? Jacob! Una pa doon sila. Una pa doon. Jacob niya bibig. The promise of the Lord. Grabe ang patuloy. Malay ko dyan ang cellphone. Wala na free. Halakaw pa yun. Okay, let's proceed. Now, condition, if you read the book of Deuteronomy chapter 11, God promised them, but there is a condition, to love the Lord with all of their heart and to hearken unto His word. That is the condition. The love of God is unconditional, but the promises of the Lord, it's any condition. Pero tabla-tabla niyo, right condition, you will receive promise. If you are disobedient, you will receive curses. If you are obedient, you will receive blessings. Both are promises. Okay, let's proceed. Abraham is the father of faith. Israel is the chosen nation. Yes or no? Now here's the question. What about us, the church? What about us, Gentiles? What's a man? If Abraham is the father of faith, then Israel is the chosen nation. What about us? Pastor, it's a verse in Psalms 2. Speaks about Jesus. And the verse that you have read speaks about the Israelites. So what about me? What about you? In the book of Romans 10:24, it says, for if thou wert cut off of the olive tree, which is valid, which is wild by nature, and wert grafted contrary to nature into the olive tree, how much more shall this, which be the natural branches, be grafted into their own olive trees? If you read this context and then the follow, listen. Every Gentile that believes in the Lord Jesus Christ will be grafted. Depart. Kumbaga, spiritually grafted, spiritually you become posa. Israelite. Okay, Pokemon, can you titata kita? From the promises to Jacob, bilang Isaac, Asapun, Abraham. Hindi ako kaya kaya kita huli yun, spiritually. Because Abraham is the father of faith. And so, if we are grafted and the promise to Abraham was given, question, will you receive the promise?
Yes.
Will you receive the promise?
Yes.
If you are grafted, si iyon mo ay anak, yan adopt yun, kabar siyang inheritance, hindi na ba receive mas yung adopted?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Third question, Ara Diakon. Sila yan, amen. Listen to what it says in the book of Romans 8:16-17. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And if children, then heirs. If heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with Him, then we may be also glorified together. We are grafted through Jesus Christ. Everybody say with me, I am grafted through Jesus Christ. But as a no one comes to the Father except through Christ. It doesn't matter what your opinion says. It does not change the truth of what God says. Manada kere kita na shelo, asa nila otro camino. Question. Yali kaya ba ito na shelo? Ito ay doon yung na shelo para asa ito camino. Another religion, as a camino, eso hace tu usted, este tu hace, pasa tu punere. ¿Sabe tu cielo? Porque yo voy contigo, si mismo si Cristo ya habla, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except for me. Why le habla ni que el tiempo tiene que otro paliga en su nombre usa? There is no retirement when it comes to God. He is eternal. He is the beginning and the end.
Amen.
We can be as children of God. Yan ang isip, el recibila, el inheritance, el promesa del inheritance. Ken man? Todo gente? Ken? Dito sa tatala ejemplo ng mga Bible study. Si Ara Aglayo. Dito ang deberasa na, di yung billionaryo ha. Baka ablas nila si Pastor Billionaryo. Si Billionaryo Aglayo. Okay. Todo de San Buanga, dahil yung 1 million kada pamilya, ako yan ang nakasa. Para na sa, para todo de San Buanga, hindi. Para de San Buanga, hindi.
Sa
todo de Sibi. Por qué man? Kaya nang abuya ko, ano isipi? Hindi ito, pre. Ito, isipi. Ay, di ba ito kaya nag-promise? Di ba ito kundi ko dati? Yabuya ito nakasa nyo. Duhay, tayo, pahay. Nag-instruction is abuya ito nakasa. Ngayabuya kay pensawa niya hindi itinirasan. Hindi, ito din yung kulpa. Ituyo yung kaya kulpa. Para na yung tente, kino na siya, no, yung kulpa ni Diyos. Hila yung kulpa. Kaya asya man sila nila older God, sige man sila nila corazon, maski nasa niya ng corazon, sige lang siyempre because what makes me happy, I'm going to do it. 2 Timothy 11:13-13, it is a faithful saying, for if we be dead with him, we shall also live with him. If we suffer, we shall also reign with him. Everybody say with me, reign. You know what's reign? What is the meaning of rain? Huh? On the central marita o sa word rain?
He.
And once you reign, what's your king? Do you have dominion? Do you have a kingdom? Yes. Revelation chapter 1:5-6. And from Jesus Christ is the faithful witness. Listen to this. We want to mention. And the first begotten of the dead. Nasaan niya? Dali po sa? Ellen begotten son. Diba? Yan ni Clele. We want to mention. And the prince of the kings of the earth, unto him that love us and wash us from our sins in his own blood. It means now you are saved. You have been forgiven because you put your faith and trust in Christ. This is what is going to happen to you. Abrió ustedes el Revelation 1:6 kasi kere no ustedes le. Para inyo ustedes ang natatanong nyo. Are you there? Okay, let's read all together. Revelation 1:6, go!
Masaya sa inyo si mga anak?
Kings and
priests.
Puro siya ang lakal kansyon. We've been created as kings and priests. To what? To worship your royalty. To proclaim his awesome and wondrous works. But sad to say, many today cling to Christianity because they want a good life. Not to worship God, they want the benefits. They don't understand what is Christianity. Por eso, el mio question tenante, do we know where we stand? Do we know our identity? Hello? 1 Peter 2:9 says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar that ye should show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. You are called to witness. You see? Uno lang yan, amen? Pero sabi nyo, God's blessings be upon you. Panatakas mo. Hallelujah.
You are called to witness. We are not called to sit para ipasino ang bangko.
Hello. Sorry kasi, idea kasi to Skype Pastor Ed. You know, comfortable na lang. Pero yung entendigan yung Pastor Ed palabra. Apart ito yung natansya. Ay, kasi manada man yung call si Lord para man pastor. At, El Pastor lang alam man siya. So si El Pastor lang man para man bring forth. Kaya this year, kung El Pastor lang na yes, kung to be a chosen generation, to be a royal priesthood, to be an holy nation, to be a peculiar people, kung El Pastor lang gali as a king and priest, yan yung question. El Pastor lang ba? Anak ni Lord? Hello? Pastor ba to? Are you a pastor? Are you a child of God?
Yes.
So are you a king and a priest?
Yes.
Hindi ito na pastor, but may I tell you, every believer is a royal priesthood. What is the inheritance?
Eternal
life. The gift of God is eternal life. Inheritance is not eternal life. If the inheritance is the kingdom of God, remember the Bible always said, whosoever lives according to the flesh shall not inherit the kingdom of God. If you don't inherit the kingdom of God, then you are not of the kingdom of God because you are not a child of God. Hello?
Hi.
Pastor, dito pwede mag-storya na lang about blessing. I'm talking about blessing. I'm talking about the ultimate inheritance. Question. Kusa mas pala inheritance? Pwede ito saka. Akin ang mundo compared to the kingdom of God. Can you compare any in this world? Can and why? Listen to what the Bible says. Seek ye first the? Seek ye first the? Seek ye first the? Because if you don't seek the kingdom of God, you will never inherit the kingdom of God. Pastor, unaulan na akong career, mga lagad na po sa Ginoo. God does not need
your help. He wants you to seek Him first because He wants you to inherit His kingdom. Are we listening? Hello?
Adi pa ba ustedes?
Second question. A second list of questions. Do you know your stand before God? Or should I change it? Do you know your relationship with God? Are you close with Him? Huh? Close man kami. So, what is your stand before God? What is your relationship? You know, maski na kinamundo, there are only two types of people that would inherit. Pwera lang si bululyago ng pamilya, ginahatag sa lahi. Yes or no? Pero normally, dos lang. The wife and the children. Say with me, the wife and the children. Porque man, pastor, the wife and the children, kaya mga wife, si Chene sila si, si Tess, maybe sila inheritance, na sila tas inguwilo ko ng husband, children lang. Pero yung husband, tapo na kat wife, pati ang children. Ne, that's true, manada more ang sila. Yes or no?
Yes.
Manada sa tarabi, pero that's the reality. No, pero pira kita, and the reality, in a scenario ba, una mo rin husband. Kung kita Christian todos, yung una man yung Muriel Moore, then yung Troy husband and children. Si una man yung Muriel husband, wife and?
Children.
Porke ganyan mention. Are you ready? Listen to what I'm going to say. When we are saved, not only we become the children of God, we are His bride. Hello? Hello. And when you marry a royalty, you become a royalty. To answer the question, what is your stand or relation to God? I am His child and I am His bride. What is your identity? I am royal and I am a priest. And if we grasp and understand that, you will understand your calling, your mission in this world, that is to what? To conquer, to possess the world for the glory of God, and then reign with Him when the time comes. For inheritance is the kingdom of God, but if you do not seek the kingdom of God, if seek means this, to evangelize and make disciples. Mauna, magsakit akong kasing-kasing, makakita ko mga kustuhanon, kay professional na daw sila, excuse na sila magbuhat sa evangelism and making disciples. I tell you, wake up before it's too late. Pastor, I am not saved by doing work. No, you're not saved by doing good works. But once you are saved, you need to understand this because this is not an opinion of the Lord. This is not a suggestion of the Lord. This is a mandate coming from Jesus Christ. Go ye therefore into all the world and preach the gospel, teaching them to observe all things. Hello. What is your inheritance? What is your inheritance? You will reign with whom? Read the book of Revelation. In the millennial reign, who is going to reign with it? Who is going to reign with Christ? The saints. Claro ba? Entende ba ta? En cansa ba na atras? Bigong tatanong ulit. What is the promise? What is the promise of the Lord? The inheritance. What is the inheritance? Kingdom of God. What is your relation to God? Child and?
Wife.
Bride. What is your identity? Royal.
You are a king. You are a priest.
Nakita ninyo unsa pagkilaya yakela yan downgrade yung Christianity na that time? Kay aral Christianity ang senior, senior. If you want to have a good life, come to Christ. Newsflash. Apenas parang tumira kong Christ, sabi ito, malisod. Kaya ablala kong nilo. You want to follow me? Deny yourself. Take up the cross. Is it a good life to deny yourself? Is it a good life to deny yourself? What if Christ told you, I know you have a good career, you have a great role in your life in this world, but my child, I am calling you to let go of your career to do my work. Will you do it? Hindi yung tabla kay ideal mga career. Tabla lang yung siyang kwento ka na po si Lord. Are we willing to do it? Are we willing to say, yes, Lord? Lord, ala pa, my son or my daughter, I know you have been together, may pamangkamukasa, pero that partner of yours is not for you. Are you willing to let go? Because my child, you were once faithful, but because of that, you are now far away from me. You are doing things not pleasing before me. Are you willing to let go? Hello? Are you willing to exchange your inheritance in heaven for the pleasures in this world? Let me end by saying this. We are called to conquer and to possess. It means evangelizing and making disciples. Remember this. We need to conquer through grace, love, and mercy. We are called to rule not like heathens. Called to rule by serving others with humility and love. If you read John 3:16 and Matthew 28:18-20, it speaks of this great love. It speaks about we going to people and evangelizing and making disciples. The only way to inherit the kingdom of God is to go through Christ. And the only way to follow and be a disciple of Christ is to deny oneself and take up the cross. I will leave you with these last lines, and I hope Unikita na korason. To the faithful ones. Or kayo sa faithful ones. Only God knows it's between you and God. So, nga para may ken kumigo rabia. To the faithful ones, God's promise is true. Our inheritance awaits us. Only be thou faithful until the end. And while we wait for his coming, let us unite, let us go, evangelize, and make disciples of all nations. Because we are told to do so as royals and priests. Good morning to all, and may God bless you. Amen. Praise God.
Wow.
Promise of inheritance. Question. Madali ba itong inheritance na muerto? Hindi, no? Siyempre, kung nag-bibo dito yung anak, the same way Jesus Christ did. That's why you need to go through the sacrifice first to bring back His people para receive kita El promise and inheritance. Amen? Now, tingnan tayo. Kita ba aki? Are we living or are we dead? Are we living in Christ or are we dead? El vivo, it means active. Amen? Hindi, firme lang doon si Juan Tamas, pero lang kaya bayabas. Mubi kita. Diba? Hindi, kita grande dito yung, ano pa si? ROI ba? ROI? Dito yung business ulit tumubi. The same way, no? God already gave us everything that we need. We just really have to own it. Own the things that God already gave us. Do not let the enemy to steal it away, to steal back what Christ already taken back for us. So I pray all of us heard the message of God for us today. And let us get lang kay entry na outro lang, Korea sa rin outro lang. Amen? Mubi kita. Tulikas ko na kasa, Lord, kung sa dito, kung sa dito niyo inheritance, kung sa tukere as, mande asin, umigo, to claim that inheritance. Hindi lang kay, huwag ito ang pastor, amen. Kabaliga na kasa, huwag niya daw yan kita. Amen. So, Ara, since we have received from God, ara namin ang dalang yung active faith. This we go to our giving. Since yan kita recipe, kailangan kita recipe kung God, I believe, manalag kita recipe. First is our life. So as we have received from God, may I pull off? Brother Toledo, Toledo, for our giving.
In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 to 7, it reads, "Did I say, ye which goeth verily spiritually, and he which soweth bountifully shall be also bountifully. Every man has the purpose in his heart, so let him give the capacity to the open sympathy, for God loves the spiritual person." Amen. Now, requesting a sign
thank you.
together the words of God for our benediction.
Most gracious, most loving Heavenly Father, our dear Jesus Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit. Lord, thank you for the word you've given upon us, Lord Jesus. Even thank you, Lord, for the cross. Yet, I
Glory, majesty, dominion, power, God, now and ever. Amen.